Components Corporation is the global leader in the design, manufacture, and engineering of precision printed circuit test points, interconnect and testing devices, printed circuit card edge connectors, preformed jumpers, hardware, and battery contacts. Visit us at www.componentscorp.com.
Welcome to the Engineering Update. I'm Casey Panetta, editor of ECN. In this week's episode, Russia's nuclear missile train, Lockheed Martin's supersonic travel, and robot security guards.
During the Cold War, both East and West developed a number of game-changing technologies and weapons in an attempt to outdo and outspend their rival. And one of the more unique contraptions from the Soviet Union was a nuclear missile train capable of traveling more than 1,000 kilometers a day across Russia's railways and deploy their arsenal along any part of the route. They first appeared in the 1980s, and now the Moscow Institute of Thermal Technology is interested in creating a new missile train as part of Russia's 10-year, $530 billion overhaul of its military. Details are still unclear, and the Moscow Institute hasn't received the final okay, but Russia's commander of their strategic missile force noted that Vladimir Putin directed that work begin on a new missile train to counter America's prompt global strike system, which could hit any target worldwide with conventional weapons inside of an hour. From a strictly engineering perspective, the old design could certainly use an upgrade. The Soviets experimented with a train armed with the RT-23 solid-fuel missile back in 1983, and a missile train regiment that deployed in 1987 toted missiles that weighed 110 tons and needed reinforced tracks to deal with the force of the prospective launch. The new missiles would weigh half that and could travel across ordinary track.
Let's face it, we're no longer impressed with the ability to travel from New York to Los Angeles in 5 hours in a cramped 737. Doesn't 2.5 hours sound much better? Lockheed Martin thinks so too, so they're working on an aircraft for commercial airlines that would cut the time spent traveling across the United States in half, from 5 hours to just 2.5, seating 80 passengers. They're running into one big challenge with the N+2 jet, however. Building a craft that can travel at supersonic speeds but not make sonic booms, which are created by objects traveling faster than 760 miles per hour, the speed of sound. The N+2 has one engine on the top side of the craft and two under the wings in a configuration designed to reduce noise. So how would it work? The aircraft would have to be very long so that the volume and the lift of the plane are allowed to gradually build up and then decrease. The engine is also extremely important. Under the N+2 program, Lockheed Martin has worked with General Electric and Rolls-Royce to look at engine concepts that have high fuel efficiency and can meet the takeoff and landing noise constraints. Lockheed Martin's manager of the NASA N+2 program told the Daily Mail that in order to achieve revolutionary reductions in supersonic aircraft noise, a totally new kind of propulsion system is being developed. They are also exploring new techniques for low-noise jet exhaust, integrated fan noise suppression, airframe noise suppression, and computer-customized airport noise abatement. Autonomous data machines might seem, at least when you first hear the term, super boring. But when you see one, they suddenly become much more interesting. Autonomous data machines, or ADMs, is actually another word for robotic security guards. Those created by the company called Nightscope are also known as K5. They're designed to act as security guards on campuses or at businesses in an effort to replace human guards and also offer protection when a human guard isn't an option. They're built for outdoors so they can monitor large school campuses, parking lots, or other areas that may be difficult for humans to constantly watch. These things are loaded with technology too. Standing at 5 feet tall, 2.5 feet wide, and 3 feet long, K5 has two light image detection and range sensors with a 20 to 67 millisecond scan time, video cameras with face and motion detection, day and night modes, auto white balance, and a backlight compensation, GPS, and license plate recognition with a video speed of 30 frames per second, and the ability to read 300 plates per minute with geotagged locations. This information is run through an algorithm that allows K5 to decide when it needs to alert someone to a problem. It also takes care of its own health with regular health status checks. When it needs to be charged, the K5 will locate a charging mat to charge the lithium-ion battery pack while continuing to monitor the situation. Unlike a human counterpart, the machine won't feel fear or hesitation, and its attention won't waver from the assigned task. Plus, if anyone tries to tamper or steal the 300-pound robot, it sends a message to the monitoring company and it sounds its own alarm. The original inspiration for the robot was events like Sandy Hook and the Boston Marathon, where crowdsourced security might have helped the situation. The robot is capable of traveling between 1 and 3 miles per hour and is fully aware of its environment and able to maneuver around obstacles. The robots won't be available for purchase, but companies will be able to rent them for just over $6 an hour. That's all for this week's episode. Be sure to check in on Twitter and Facebook and watch past episodes at ecnmag.com. For the ACN channel, I'm Casey Panetta, and this has been your engineering update.